This is Josh with 9 Hole Reviews here from MidwayUSA, and today we're talking optics, specifically first focal plane versus second focal plane optics. Which might be right for your rifle? Let's get right into it. All right, first focal plane, that's FFP versus second focal plane, SFP optics. Well, the real difference between these two types of optics comes down to their physical construction. That's because in a first focal plane optic, the reticle is actually built in the tube in front of the magnification, whereas in a second focal plane optic, it is behind the magnification. This means in a first focal plane, the reticle actually zooms in and out with your magnification. So as you dial magnification up, you zoom into the reticle, and as you minimize magnification, the reticle actually shrinks as well. Contrast that against a second focal plane optic where the reticle is always one size, one image, the same always, whether you're on min, max, or anywhere in between. So why would you want a reticle to be changing size? Well, if you have any sort of measurement within the reticle, mil dot reticle, BDC points, ranging features, a full-on Christmas tree grid, well, those will be true to measure on a first focal plane optic, regardless of where you are within the magnification span. Because again, the reticle is changing size to maintain those points of measure being true to scale at the varying magnification levels. In a second focal plane optic, that is not the case. If you're below max magnification or above min magnification, anywhere in between, they are not going to be true to size actual reticle measures. So that's a pretty big downside to a second focal plane optic and reticle setup. Or is it? Well, this depends upon how the second focal plane optic is being utilized. So a great example is this Collis K16i. This is a 1:6 LPVO and it is second focal plane. That means when I'm looking through here at 6 power all the way down to 1 power, the reticle looks exactly the same. And so if I'm at, let's say, 4 power and I'm trying to utilize this reticle at distance, well, the measures within the mil grid here will not be true to size. But how often am I actually shooting a 1:6 power optic on something less than 6 power where I would also need the mil measurements? You know, that's 400 plus yards away in terms of the target where I would actually start to need to use my mil tree here. And frankly, I'm probably going to be dialed to 6 power when I'm doing that. Now, contrast that with a totally different type of optic. This is the Primary Arms GLX. This is a 4:16. It is entirely reasonable that I might be utilizing this optic and need the mil holdovers, but not be dialed all the way to 16 power. Perhaps I might be at 10, 12, or 14 power, and I still need to be able to use the mils effectively. I might be shooting at 600 or 700 with magnification of that at that level. And so again, the higher the magnification is in your scope and the wider the range of magnification, the likelihood of you needing a first focal plane optic goes up a lot. The best example I can give here is if I'm using a precision rifle optic, something like a 5:25, well, the odds of me being dialed all the way to 25 power are almost none for 95% of what I'm doing with that gun. I'm probably going to be anywhere between 12 and 18 power the majority of the time I'm using that optic, shooting out from 0 to 1,000, let's say. And so I absolutely need a first focal plane reticle because I need the measures to be correct within that magnification span. Now you might be asking, well, why not then just always have a first focal plane? That way, if you happen to shoot something like a 1:6, but be on 4 power, whether by accident or for some particular reason, you would still have the ability to use the mil measurements correctly. Well, this comes down to the second main consideration here, and that is how the reticle actually looks. See, when you're using a reticle in a first focal plane optic, it's been our experience that the reticle is usually designed with a bias, either towards enhanced magnification or less magnification, meaning the reticle looks better and more usable at one end of the spectrum or the other. So if I have a reticle that looks really good on the low end of the spectrum, when I get up to the high end of the spectrum, it may look overly thick. It may not be particularly precise. And the same could be true the other direction. If it looks great at the top end of the spectrum, but then I dial it back down and need to use it on the low end of the spectrum, the reticle in the crosshair may look really thin and hard to track, for example. And that is definitely true on something like LPVOs. It is routine to see reticles that are really nice at one power in a first focal plane body, but as you dial them up, they look really thick and chunky when you get to 6 or 8 power. And so they are easy to shoot up close and to track, but when you get to max magnification and you're shooting a distance, the reticle is extremely chunky and covers huge portions of your target. And then the inverse is true, whereas if you have a reticle that looks good on target, let's say at 6 or 8 power, but then I dial it down to 1 to be able to shoot up close and do sort of the run and gun style shooting, well, the reticle is really fine and can be hard to track, especially through recoil or snapping the gun up on target. So there are actually some real considerations and trade-offs here depending upon the type of shooting you're intending to do and what your rifle is set up for. And then there's the economy of this entire endeavor. And while this isn't a hard rule, it is generally true that second focal plane optics tend to be a bit cheaper than their first focal plane counterparts. So that might be something to consider as well. So in summary, if you are shooting with a medium to high magnification optic, anywhere between like a 2 to 10 or a 3 to 12, a 4 to 16, a 5 to 25, in all of those particular optics, it is going to be routine for you to not be dialed all the way to max magnification and still potentially need to use the mil grids or the measurements within the reticle. And as such, you probably always want a first focal plane optic. Conversely, if you are using an LPVO, well, the answer here is much more split down the middle. You can absolutely find plenty of people who are shooting second focal plane LPVOs to maximum effect and utilizing them very effectively because when you're shooting at distance where you actually need the mils or the reticle or the MOA, BDC, whatever is going on inside the optic to be true to measure, you're probably always on max magnification. So, when it comes down to making the right choice for you, keep all these things in mind. Until next time, we'll see you on the range.